Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create your own eye-catching poster design inspired by the artist Victor Vasarely, who's considered the grandfather and leader of the op art movement, which became popular in the mid-1960s. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, click the subscribe button at the lower right corner or in my video's description below. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N or by going to File and New. Make its width and height 1.5 inches each and the resolution 300 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then click Create or Open. To fit it onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll create the first shape of our pattern. After we create the basic design of the pattern, we'll place it onto four quadrants. To do this, go to View and make sure Snap is checked. If it isn't, just click it to make it active. If you're using a Photoshop version earlier than CC, make sure Rulers is checked as well. If your version is earlier than CC, I'll show you what to do in a minute. For CC and later, click New Guide Layout. Make the number of columns and rows both 2 and leave everything else empty. For versions earlier than CC, go to the top ruler and drag out a guideline until it snaps to the center. Go to the left ruler and do the same. Open your Custom Shape tool. At the top, choose Shape. If you're using CS5 or earlier, the Shape tool is here. The fill is black, and the stroke is empty. Open the Shape window and click the small gear icon. Choose whatever shape presets you like. If you want to see all of them at once, click All. I'll click Shapes. When you see this message, click OK to replace the current shapes with the shapes you just picked. I'll click this one. Keep in mind, the shapes and colors that I'll be using in this tutorial are just examples. Feel free to adjust your pattern with any shapes and colors you like, and feel free to mix and match. Click the gear icon at the top. I'll tick Define Proportions and check From Center. Go to the center of the guidelines and drag out the shape. Double-click an empty area of the shape layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. Pick a color. You can always change it later if you want. Open your shapes again and pick another. I'll pick this one. Go to the center and drag out this shape. I'd like the circle to go behind the square. You can place your shapes over or under other shapes by dragging their layers above or below other layers in the Layers panel. Double-click an empty area of this shape's layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay, the color box, and pick a color for this shape. Continue these steps to add shapes to your pattern, and feel free to play with their opacities as well. Once you have a pattern you like, we'll reduce its size and place them into four quadrants. To do this, scroll to the top of the Layers panel and make the top shape layer active. Scroll to the bottom and shift-click the bottom shape to make all the shape layers active. We'll place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to the bottom right corner of the Transform's bounding box, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it to the upper left quadrant, making sure it's aligned with the guidelines. Then press Enter or Return. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press and hold Shift as you drag the copy to the right until it snaps to the right corner. Make another copy and drag it straight down until it snaps to the lower right corner. Make one more copy and drag it to the left until it snaps in place. We can hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Next, we'll adjust the colors of each pattern. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. An adjustment layer affects all the layers beneath it in the Layers panel unless we clip it to the one layer beneath it. To do this, press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac or click the Clipping Mask icon. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Now, our adjustment layer will only affect the one folder beneath it. Drag the hue slider to the left or right until you like the combination of colors for that particular pattern. Make the Copy To folder active and click the adjustment layer icon again. Click Hue Saturation. Clip it to that folder and adjust its hues. Repeat these steps with the top right pattern. We'll place all four color combinations into a folder by making the top adjustment layer active and shift-clicking the bottom folder. Press Ctrl or Command G. We'll save the pattern without the white background. Click the eyeball icon next to the white background to hide it. Then go to Edit and Define Pattern. I'll type in Op Art. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Create a new document. Make its width and height 12 inches and its resolution 300 pixels per inch. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Pattern. I'll keep the scale at 100%. Make a copy of the pattern and the background by shift-clicking the background to make it active as well and pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the background copy and fill it with black by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete, which fills it with a foreground color. Make the original background active. We'll fill it with 50% gray by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard or by going to Edit and Fill. Open Contents and click 50% gray. If we hide the black background, we can see the gray background behind the pattern. I'll click the eyeball icon again to make the black background visible. We'll convert the pattern copy and the black background into one smart object so we can distort its shape non-destructively. Go to Filter, Distort, and Spherize. Make the amount 100% and click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll spherize it more by pressing Ctrl-Alt-F on Windows or Command-Option-F on a Mac. Press Enter or Return and invoke the filter one more time. Open your elliptical marquee tool and go to a corner. Press and hold the Shift key as you drag a circular selection to the opposite corner. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer, which masks out the pattern outside the sphere. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.